being a mental health advocate is something that I feel like I was thrust into. My name is Alexandra Nyman. I am the founder and creative director of Lady Cat, and I also founded and put together Break Free New York Fashion Week, which is a runway show with a cause. We just finished up our premiere runway show on Valentine's Day, which was February 14th. And I'm also the editor-in-chief of Soberosity, which is an online sober blog. And we also have a Facebook group for those looking for support and to reach out to other members of the sober and the sober curious community. The whole thesis of the show is that mental health and substance use disorders affects everybody. It was just awe-inspiring, the amount of representation that we were able to bring to the runway and the amount of inclusivity. I made sure to find designers who had this message at the core of their brand. So whether it be that they themselves are an advocate or they personally are affected by mental health or substance use disorders. Jacqueline City, who is another phenomenal designer, and she has such a moving story. She's a disabilities activist, and she brought so much representation to the runway with Sarah and her sister Emily, where Emily is the youngest individual to walk with Down syndrome at only the age of 15 during New York Fashion Week. Zephyr, which is by Kelsey Zephyr. She has DID, or a form of it, which is dissociative personality disorder. And she has multiple different alters that live within her as this beautiful, collaborative, artistic community. And she brought that alive within her collection, where each of her 8 different looks represented a different alter of herself. She had her artist, she had her academic, she had her vixen, and it was so moving to see her community come together and to see her to be able to have that representation and to be able to uplift an entire community, because out of everyone within the mental health community, that disorder is one that is so often misunderstood and marginalized. To me, knowing Kelsey has been an extreme honor and a privilege, because she's a quintessential artist and she is a phenomenal designer. And it was just wild to me that when I reached out to her, she didn't want to call herself a designer. She was like, oh no, I do cosplay. And I was like, no, you are a fashion designer. You do fashion design and you are talented and you should be involved in this showcase, because anybody who can sew and can design deserves them to call themselves a fashion designer. Fashion doesn't need to be some exclusive club where only a select few can only hope to be able to one day call themselves a fashion designer. If you sew, if you make clothes, I'm sorry if this offends you, but you're a fashion designer. We have designers like Alexander McQueen, who very publicly struggled with a substance use disorder and with this mental health. And ultimately, it led to him committing suicide. And he's somebody that, on the surface, he had it all. She no longer owned her brand, Kate Spade, New York. But she felt that because her brand is so cheerful and so vibrant, that if she went to go pursue help, it would damage her brand. And so instead of reaching out and getting help, like her sister had been begging her and her loved ones, she ended her own life. So to me, this showcase embodies an outcry and a need for designers and models and people who work within the industry to speak out and to destigmatize these issues. Because if we don't, we're going to continue to see these tragedies, and we're going to continue to be like, oh my gosh, how did this happen? Why did this happen? When the answer has been there all along. We've seen these people struggling, and we don't say anything, and we don't reach out, and we act as if they're fine, everything's fine. We take advantage of the fact that there's always a tomorrow, and we can see them tomorrow, and we can ask them if they're okay tomorrow, when we should be reaching out right now, today. I mean, it's cliche to say, but if you see somebody struggling, you should say something. Be an advocate for him, and to educate myself on, well, how do I help you, and what can I do to ease your burden? You know, beyond that, I also suffer from depression and anxiety myself. It was easier for me to jump in and fully embrace and focus on helping my younger brother with everything that he was experiencing and going through. And I spent years in denial of my own mental health and my own issues. Being that little girl in third grade, being diagnosed with ADHD and dyslexia, not wanting to accept it, not wanting to go there, and just being like, yeah, no, I'm fine, I'm normal, I'm good. Even though I am like the first person to tell my friends, family, peers, like, you need to get help, like, you should talk to a therapist, we gotta normalize this, like, shouting to the rooftops, like, being an advocate, being like a role model, and like, not taking any of my own advice. In 2019, I did my first collection therapy, which told the story of my younger brother's bipolar diagnosis, and it went from his suicide attempt all the way up to him thriving and being like the wonderful human being that he is now. And he's like sitting there waiting for the piece to play, and it doesn't play. And my heart broke. It's human error. But for me, it affected me so greatly. But I was like, okay, it's fine. I have another show in a week. I'm just gonna see this as like practice run. And then the other show went even worse. And I never wanted to sew again. I never wanted to do a collection again. I didn't share the pictures. I didn't want to even talk about it, so I didn't. I acted like that showcase didn't exist. And I didn't sew for 7, 8, 9 months. I didn't leave my bed for maybe 2 months. Something's wrong. I'm not gonna tell my brother or my family, because like, I'm the successful one, I'm the strong one. I'm the one that like moved out first. I'm the one that has the like big New York job. And I was like, so I'm depressed. And she was like, you look fine. Because I was like dressed professionally, I looked like I had showered and everything, and I was like, so I have, this is the first time I've gotten out of bed in 2 months, I've barely showered, not self-caring. And then she was like, so I'm gonna start you off on Zoloft. You present yourself very well. And I was like, well, I'm very good at that. But that doesn't mean that I don't need help. And that's how it started. There's something wrong in the village, in the village. Oh, they stare in the village, in the village. Oh, there's nothing wrong with you. It's true, it's true. There's something wrong with the village, with the village. There's something wrong with the village. Feel the rumors follow you from Monday all the way to Friday dinner. You got one day of shelter, then it's Sunday hell to pay, you young lost sinner. Well, I've been there sitting in that same chair, whispering that same prayer half a million times. It's a lie though, burying disciples, one page of the Bible isn't worth a life. There's something wrong in the village.